talking about technology, you develop your own like systems, and you have a digital platform that you develop called Twang. What is it about your technologies that they're solving in the market that was lacking?
When we did Mood 2012, well, it went live 2012, but we actually started to do Mood already on drawings 2010. I thought there would be like you have when it comes to how you privately consume music, there's a lot of good platforms and softwares for that. So I thought like there must be, of course, for the on the professional side as well. So we start, you know, to hunt for that kind of software. And there was no software for what we wanted to do. We wanted a software to be able to schedule, of course, time, day, year. We wanted the software to be able to bring out different content on different scheduling with different volumes. We also wanted the software to be able to bring out different layer of sound. And we also wanted the software to, if you want to put out like some sort of a message, that you could actually do it on exact time. And then we wanted the software to tell us if it wasn't playing, and also for the customer to have some sort of remote. So the software should, you know, if we're telling that like this zone is going to start 6 o'clock in the morning on the volume, blah, 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 with this content, 8 o'clock, you're going to change content to this content. You're going to play it between 8 and 9. 9 o'clock, you're going to change content again, and you're going to put the volume up. 2 o'clock, you're going to take the volume down. 4 o'clock, you're going to change content, put the volume down or up or whatever. And let's say 9 o'clock in the evening, you should just tell people like, thank you for visiting, see you tomorrow and goodbye. And then it's going to close down. There was no software like that. So we had to figure out how are we going to bring out the concepts, the sound design concepts we want to do. It's not going to be possible if we cannot do this. We need a software, because otherwise it's just going to be a playlist. It's just going to be a volume. And someone, the customer, has then to go somewhere in their phone or somewhere to put the volume up or down or whatever. It doesn't make sense.
No.
So then we found people that was helping us building it. And now we are launching a new one in, I think it's going to be launched in March, April, where we actually developed even more. We've been developing new things all the time, of course. But now we're changing the platform and the software totally. Yeah.
Oh, wow. I can't wait to see more of it. And when you talk about sound and music, then I'm interested to understand, how much of it do you produce in-house, or how much of it do you like source?
We do both. I think if you're going to have like a store chain like Åhléns or Mood Stockholm, there's no way that you can produce all the content yourself, because it's not going to be very good content in the end. I mean, if you're going to create like a good song, first of all, you need to be not even the most successful songwriters are making quality hits all the time. So to have really good quality music, you need to buy good quality music. So we buy a lot of music, of course, because we have a professional license, so we can buy any music we want, and we do. And then we produce also, of course, if you do audio branding, that is totally 100% composed by us. And if you do unique sound productions, and of course sound layering and nature sounds, all of that we are producing. But when it comes to music, if you want to have good quality music, you should be able to buy everything that really, really good people already created.